This is the average time traces of single and multiple sensory stimulus combinations in representative cortical areas. For example, in the primary sensory area, S1, there are evoked responses to small sensory stimulation. In contrast, in higher association areas like M2 and the parietal area, one health oscillatory responses are observed after stimulation that matches the frequency range of cortical slow wave activity. Evidently, in multisensory association cortex, oscillations are not directly evoked by sensory stimulation, but rather reflect phase locking to ongoing oscillations in excitatory networks, with smaller changes seen in inhibitory networks. To quantify this phenomenon, we introduce a phase locking factor to indicate to what extent the phases of the oscillations were aligned between trials. We detected a significant increase in the phase locking factor after sensory stimulation in both sensory and association cortex. In some sensory combinations, we detected prolonged phase locking across many cortical areas for a few seconds after stimulation onset. Phase locking in the inhibitory network was also observed, but values were significantly lower than in the excitatory network. In association networks, the phase locking factor was amplified during multisensory stimulation. This is a schematic movie of slow wave oscillation phase locking. The sinusoidal curves represent slow wave oscillations from single trials in medial and parietal cortical areas. When sensory input is stimulated, the phases of the oscillations become locked, and this effect is enhanced during multisensory stimulation. Such phasic interactions are crucial for brain network communication, and slow wave phase locking can be a mechanism of multisensory integration.